The number 25 Iowa State Cyclones will be taking on the Pioneers from Texas Women's University. Hello and welcome inside Hilton Coliseum. I'm Patrick Tarbox, joined once again this week by Courtney Horseman. Iowa State is coming off season-low score, 194.975 last week at Oklahoma. Courtney, what's key to Iowa State bouncing back tonight?
It's important for them to stay focused and not get nervous at all. The less stress they have, the better they'll do.
Should be a good meet tonight for Iowa State. Join us for the first rotation when we come back. This is Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by Mediacom.
Perfect handstands and sticking landings are the keys to success on bars for Iowa State senior Hillary Green. Green scored a 9.9 on bars last weekend at Oklahoma, and the Big 12 named her the event specialist of the week for her performance.
I've been doing that bar routine for the past 4 years now, and I've scored a 9.9 my freshman and sophomore year, but it hadn't happened since then, so it was really exciting. But I'd especially like to credit like my team members for that kind of performance, because we feed off of each other, and fortunately it happened, so really exciting.
This team does feed off each other, and it is a very close group. The Cyclones return the entire squad from last year, and Green is one of the senior leaders guiding the team from her anchor position in the bars lineup.
It can be a challenging role, but it's fun knowing that they all trust you to hit your routine, and that no matter what happens before me, I know myself and I feel like I can get the job done, and I do it for all of them.
Every single time, whether it's in practice or at the meet, we could have like a little mistake or someone maybe a little down themselves, we can look to her, and she's always positive no matter what, and she has confidence in herself that she'll make it, and for herself and for us.
After not having the success she hoped for during her junior campaign, Green is ready to make the most of her senior season and not hold anything back.
She's been capable of 9.9 routines for years, but she's always been a little bit tight when it comes time to get the job done. So she's unafraid to make that mistake now, so she really attacks the event, and she goes all out every single time now, and that's what's going to get her to her goals.
Yeah, and those times I would rush a lot, but Jay always reminds me, just swing bars. And like from the day I very started gymnastics, I absolutely love bars, and there's no reason to rush the routine. Like, you're out there to perform and to really take your time and hit those handstands and just enjoy every single moment. So really this year is about enjoying the moment and getting the job done.
And this senior is taking advantage of all the moments, both in and out of the gym. Green received academic All Big 12 first team honors the last two seasons, is an active member of the Student Athlete Advisory Committee, works as a research assistant in the Food Science and Human Nutrition Department, and was selected by the Office of Student Athlete Development as one of the Student Athletes of the Semester for her performance in the classroom last fall. Oh, and did I mention she also traveled on a mission trip with Souls for Souls this summer?
So I've always wanted to travel to a third world country, and Haiti has always been one on my heart. And to be able to go there, I was so grateful that ICU Athletics provided that kind of opportunity. The one thing about those people is they're just so loving and so grateful, and it's kind of nice to be outside of our, you know, first world problems, I guess, per se, and you kind of take a step back and reevaluate.
I would say one of the biggest things is her positivity. Whether she's had a school day from 8 a.m. to 2 o'clock and she's in the gym, she's smiling, she's happy, she's not only doing things for herself, but she's helping others who might be having a bad day or having trouble making something. She's always helping other people and bringing just a great atmosphere to the gym.
Whether it is in the classroom, helping others, or working on her gymnastic skills, Green is ready to put in the work to achieve her goals.
She knows this is her last shot, and she's completely all in. She's now taking care of everything outside of the gym as well as inside of the gym that it takes to be an All-American. Every day she is coming in here with a mission, and she's working toward it.
I never thought I would be where I am right now, so I really reflect on it a lot. You know, all I can do is credit to God, because that's a God-given thing right there. And going forward, I just will take what I learn, and you know, this season of life may be ending, but I can apply it to the future.
And the future is definitely bright for Hillary Green. For Cyclones.tv, I'm Danny Orris.
We're underway here between Iowa State and Texas Women's University. You're looking at Kelly Martin on vault.
Beautiful Uchenko full with just a small hop there.
Good start to the vault lineup for the Iowa State Cyclones. Same lineup as it's been as well as last week for Iowa State, Kelly Martin, Brianna Ledesma, Kelsey Paz, Sophia Steinmeier, Megan Sievers, and Haley Young. As you take a look at Texas Women's University, getting ready to go underway on the bars. So we're going to get another look at Kelly's vault here.
That was a beautiful Yuchenko full, as you see. She does have that hop there. But it was a great start for the Cyclones on vault.
Quick little delay over at bars. I believe there was a lineup change there. Get that confirmed here momentarily. And that's our delay here. Let's see if we can get the score on Kelly Martin there. They're involved as they continue to get the lineup situation finalized over on the bars for Texas Women's University. Head coach Lisa Bowerman was over here during the warm-ups while you were watching that Hillary Green package. Going through a few quick lineup changes for TWU. Kelly Martin starts out with a 9.725. Ties her season high. Good start for the Cyclones there.
Yes, they're definitely going to like that score to start out this event and to start out this meet tonight.
While we have some time here, let's run through who the key gymnasts are for you, Courtney.
On vault, we have Megan Sievers. Megan puts up a huge vault. On bars, we have Laura Burns. Laura does a beautiful bar routine. Beam, Kelsey Paz, up there, confident all the time. And on floor, we have Brianna Ledesma, very powerful.
As we head back over to the uneven bars, Pioneers are underway.
Starting out this routine with a swing half bail up to the high bar. Nice double layout. Great routine to start off for Texas.
Good start for Texas Women's University there. That was Abigail Versman, senior from Cottleville, Missouri. It's her season debut on the uneven bars there. As we get a look at Brianna Ledesma here, getting ready to roll for the Cyclones on the vault.
Des does a Yuchenko full as well. Huge Yuchenko full, and she sticks that landing. She's very happy, as you see her celebrating with her teammates.
So I think we'll definitely see a new season high for Des there. She came in with a season high of 9.650, so.
That's definitely going to top off her
absolutely,
season high.
Absolutely agree with that. To get another look at it here.
Huge Yuchenko full. She does have a small hop there, but she's very happy with that. That's definitely going to score high.
It's always nice when an emotional gymnast like Des gets a good score. She really gets fired up and helps pump up her teammates, especially that early in the vault lineup.
Yes, it helps a lot because she's like that in practice as well. If she hits a great bar routine or floor routine, she gets that excited, and the girls get pumped up and ready for their routines.
Look at the Texas Women's University bars lineup there. Just Versman, you got Morgan Colley, Bria Northrup, Hunter Vincent, Shiler Jones, who is their all-arounder, and Alyssa Kelly to close it out. You'd say they're finalizing the scores on the first gymnast there. At the moment, see Mary Ronayne running around the background there, helping get things organized, get judges' slips to the right people and stuff. Hard work going through by the Iowa State gymnastics staff. Okay, so the lineup change is that now we're seeing Abigail Versman go on bars. The first gymnast you saw was Megan Gentry, who got a 9.5.
Ooh, she does a reverse hecht, and she does not make it.
It's a 9.525 for Gentry, excuse me, with the quick correction there.
She has 30 seconds to go chalk up, talk to her coach, take a deep breath, and finish off this routine. Sometimes it's tough to fall during a bar routine because you have to get up and finish it, and sometimes it can be too tiring than actually doing the whole routine. Let's see if she can finish this routine out strong. Beautiful bail to a toe sit-up. Just a little shy in that last handstand. Lining up for her dismount. Double layout, just a hop forwards.
Good recovery by her there. Quick score update from the vault. Brianna Ledesma did get her season high, and she matches Kelly Martin with a 9.725. Kelsey Paz.
Kelsey does a huge Yuchenko full hop backwards, but they're definitely going to like that vault for sure.
Kelsey celebrating there with her teammates. New Leos this week for Iowa State. New look for the Cyclones. Looks good.
Yeah, they look very good.
Gonna look at that vault by Kelsey.
Very happy with that vault for sure. See her reaction there.
Good start going for Iowa State on vault. Iowa State had a good performance on vault last week against Oklahoma, 49-0-7-5 in that meet. Against the Sooners, finished the meet as well, so it was a very impressive way to wrap up the meet for the Cyclones.
Yeah, last meet was a little rough for them, but they've been in the gym working hard, trying to stay motivated so that they can come out today on top and with a pretty high team score.
Still getting things situated over at the uneven bars as wait for scores to come in and get finalized. I'm going to get a score here for Kelsey Paz. 9-8 for Kelsey Paz on her vault. That ties her season high in week four of the Iowa State season. This is Texas Women University's third meet of the season. They started the season against Lindenwood. And then, they, of course, they were in Norman last week with us and the number one Oklahoma Sooners. Ready to go here.
It's always nerve-wracking waiting for those judges to salute you, because you have to stand there and think about your routines. Sometimes you just get distracted and you don't want that to happen, of course.
This is Morgan Coley for the Pioneers. She's a junior, but this season is her first time competing for TWU. She has competed on vault, bars, and floor for them.
She starts out her routine with a beautiful chapash into a bail.
Quick score update for TWU. Versman with her fall and her routine got an 8.875.
Winding up for her dismount. Double out, but she does have to pike that down. But she did do a solid routine before that dismount.
TWU ladies looking to not count that fall. One of our favorite vaults to watch here, Sophia Steinmeier.
Sophia has a huge vault. She has a Yuchenko 1.5. Just a small step backwards, but that was a great vault by Sophia.
Good work in the air by Sophia there. She congratulated her teammates. As Courtney observed, there's a little step back on the finish as we see her here.
Yeah, she was just a little short on that landing, which had to force her to step back, but it was a great big vault by Sophia.
Able to hang on to it, get her a score. Sophia's had an outstanding start to the season on vault. She got 2.9825 with a 9.85 in there as well, which you saw here 2 weeks ago against Arizona.
I remember when I first walked into the gym seeing her vault, it was huge and like my jaw was on the floor. She has an amazing vault and I could watch that vault for the rest of her life.
Yeah, that's the thing, is like you see the gymnastics circles talk about how they're bringing in a 10-0 vault. This is a serious vault, and you're like, oh, okay, it's 10-0 vault. Let's see. And then you see it in person, you're like, wow, like so much power, and she's very precise with what she does in the air as well.
Mm-hmm. And she put up a 9.775 on that vault.
So continue to build on her season there. Collie's score comes in. She gets a 9.575 for TWU over on the bars. Bria Northrup up for the Pioneers. Northrup is a sophomore from Shawnee, Kansas. Season high 9.675, career high 9.8.
Beautiful first handstand into a clear hip. As she goes into a ginger, connects it to an overshoot. She hits that last handstand. She's winding up for her dismount now. Beautiful double layout. Just lands with her chest down a little bit, which forces her to step forwards, but a great routine.
Yeah, really nice routine for Northrup. Very strong first two handstands. Not easy to do that early in a routine when you know you have so much more to do, but it was really good out of her. Speaking of big vaults, Megan Sievers.
Front handspring, front pike half, Just a little hop backwards, but that was a great vault by Megan Sievers.
Outstanding work by Megan Sievers. Season high 9.875, career high 9.925 for Sievers. We see her vault here again.
Sky high. As you see, she has a lot of power, and she is capable of sticking that.
Should be a nice score for the Cyclones there as Sievers gets a few tips from head coach Jay Ronayne after that routine. They see Haley Young there getting ready. She will be Iowa State's final competitor on the vault when the time comes. Another good crowd here at Hilton Coliseum enjoying the competition and their clone cones as well. We always thank the fans who are here and thank the fans who are watching at home on Cyclones.tv. We get ready for TWU on the bars. This is Skylar Jones. She's a senior, a local kid, Texas Women's University, located in Denton, Texas. She is from Denton, and she is their lone all-arounder.
Beautiful first handstand. Blindfold into a ganger, just a little close to the bar there, but she pulls it out. Short on the handstand with the bailout. She hits that last handstand as she winds up for her dismount. Blindfold into a double tuck, and she sticks the landing.
For TWU, Bria Northrup on the previous routine got a 9.800. See this, Haley Young, she's had a really good start to the season on the vault. She's got a 9.9 to her name this year.
Haley does a Uchenko full, and she has a small hop back, but it was a great vault by Haley Young. The Cyclones are definitely happy with this vault rotation.
Yes, it's been a really, really good vault rotation for Iowa State. A lot of consistency, 1 through 6, as we see her vault here one more time.
A huge full. She actually does stick that. She does not hop back from the angle I sit at. Looked like she did.
Hope the judges agree to see Megan Sievers' score come into the bug there. Final bars routine for TWU, Alyssa Kelly. It's Kelly, another senior for TWU. Season high 9.800, career high 9.825 to her name as they work to finalize the score over there. We got a start value disagreement over there. I think that goes back to what happened on the release move in the previous routine. See, we've got a score coming in for Haley Young here. 9.825 for Haley Young. Spinning around there. The calculation go in to figure out Iowa State's final vault score. See it come through there. 48.975 for Iowa State on vault. 10th lower than last week, but still very good score this early in the season. And Iowa State, it's nice. It seems like they got a nice settled lineup in there, 1 through 6. Maybe change around a little bit who goes where, but I think Jay knows who. He's got a good 6 out there.
Yes, he definitely does. And we do have other gymnasts in the gym who vault. Ari is actually out with an injury, and she has a great Uchenko full as well.
Yep.
So adding her score in there, and a couple of other girls, Cindy Converse, who is out, who had surgery on her Achilles. She does a huge Uchenko full as well. So once they get healthy and put them back in lineup, we can have a huge team score for vault.
Absolutely. So we see the judges conversing over at the bars. We got Janelle Buseman and Brooke Bennett are the judges today over on the bars. Their meeting is done. See if they can come to an agreement with a score for Skylar Jones. So we will get you that score during Kelly's routine as Kelly waits for her signal. Judges get settled back in. Wait for the signal from Janelle Buseman here. 9-1 for Skylar Jones, a little deduction for what happened on the release maneuver, and here goes Kelly.
Nice first cat's handstand. She gets a blind change into a nice Jaeger. Oh, and she does miss that kip into the handstand. Ooh, and her hand slips on that bail. Hopefully she can finish this routine out strong.
Just a little shy on that cast handstand. Winding up for her dismount. Ooh, her hand actually slipped.
Good effort by TWU. She gets some advice from her assistant coach there, Stephen Hood. And that ends the first rotation. See the scores there.
Coach Kristen White. And right off the back, Coach, what can you say about what you thought about the team's performance on the vault?
Vault was a great start for us. You know, we're looking to hit 24 for 24 routines today. So hopefully we can just keep this momentum rolling into the next three events.
And Megan Sievers had a very strong 9.850. What did you think about her finish?
Oh, it was a great vault for Megan. She's always been a strong competitor for us. So we were very pleased with that vault.
And outside of the meet right now, Hillary Green was named Event Specialist of the Week for the Big 12. What do you think about her performance thus far in the season?
Hillary has done a phenomenal job for us this year. You know, not only in the gym, but also in the classroom and outside the community. I mean, she's a great role model, not just for our team, but for everybody. So we're very pleased with her performance so far, and we hope that she continues to have a great rest of the season.
All right, thank you, Coach. You are watching Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by MediaCom.
9.85 score for Texas Women's University, 46.675. See the Iowa State lineup there, led by a 9.850 by Megan Sievers. Haley Young, 9.825. Nice 9.8 from Kelsey Paz. Sophia Steinmeier, 9.7725. Kelly Martin, 9.725. And Brianna Ledesma, 9.675. As we make our way over to the uneven bars. Cyclones warming up right now for their second rotation. See Brianna Ledesma there. We could be seeing her. So there's still some indecision about that first spot in the lineup. Nelson Darrow Savage there. Still determining who he wants to go with, whether he wants to go with MJ Johnson or Brianna Ledesma. We will find out soon enough. The other five pretty much set in stone. Kelsey Paz, Laura Burns, Megan Sievers, Haley Young, and the anchor and defending Big 12 Event Specialist of the Week, Hillary Green. See at Texas Women's University vault lineup where we'll start this out. Warren Colley, Aaron Alderman, Megan Gentry, Mallory Morduck, Brandy Lazarus, and Shiloh Jones. So Texas Women's University looking for a rebound after that rough first rotation on uneven bars. They got some talent on vault, though. Last week at Oklahoma, it went 48-9, so they can put up some good scores. As we see Kali get ready here, seasoning career high, 9.750.
She does a Uchenko full. Just a little hop backwards, but a great start for Texas Women's.
Impressive vault. She gets some good air on that. Good start for TWU. And it will be MJ leading off the Iowa State bars lineup.
Beautiful mount by MJ. Just a little shy in that first handstand. She does a blind change into a ginger. Beautiful. She hits that handstand to a shoot over. She has to just hit this last handstand and stick her dismount. A little shy there. She winds up for her dismount, and she'll do a full in. Beautiful dismount and routine by MJ.
Really nice start to the rotation for Iowa State by MJ Johnson. MJ comes into the meet, season high 9.725, career high 9.825. We're going to see her again here on the replay.
She has beautiful form on bars. You see that toe point. Beautiful dismount.
This is Aaron Alderman, junior from Fair Oaks, California. Season high 9.675, career high 9.775.
She's definitely a powerful gymnast. She has a Uchenko layout full. Just a little hop backwards, but a great second vault for Texas.
Said these are really good on the vault for TWU. Congratulated by her teammates. So we head back over to the bars. Get a look at Kelsey Paz there. Oh, look at that. Haley Young. Guys, a fan there in the stands.
I love seeing all the big heads nowadays at competitions. Yep. Kelsey's a great competitor on bars. Can always trust her to hit her routine.
9.65 for MJ as Kelsey Paz gets underway. Give you a quick vault score here. Morgan Colley got a 9.675 to lead off for TWU on the ball.
Kelsey starts off with a clear up into a huge staccato, connected into her overshoot. She hits that last handstand. She does a double layout as her dismount. Huge double layout. Just a little hop backwards, but a great routine done by Kelsey Paz.
Got another look here at Paz's routine.
Huge double out, like I said before. She's definitely happy with that routine.
Megan Gentry underway here.
Uchenko out full, just a little chest down on the landing, so had to take a hop forwards, but a great vault for Texas.
Alderman got a 9.775 for TWU in their second spot of the rotation. Say working on finalizing Kelsey Paz's score over on the uneven bars. Coming up next for Iowa State will be Laura Burns.
Laura is our athlete to watch for the day on bars. She has a beautiful bar routine. Her form is nearly perfect. She can hit all of her handstands, and she has a huge release move in the beginning of her routine, and you don't see it often in college gymnastics, but when you see a huge release move like that, it makes the judges in the crowd, like, say, wow.
9.725 for Kelsey Paz. Here goes Laura.
She hits that first handstand. Here's that release move. Huge. You see she catches on her fingertips, but she hangs onto the bar. Ooh, and she just opens up a little too early on her toe hand. So she repeats it. Perfect the second time. A beautiful bail. She missed her foot on for her round. She hits that last handstand. She has a double layout as her dismount. Beautiful double layout, just a small step.
As we talked about, she has the pieces there for the big routine. You need to string them all together. We saw a lot of really impressive things she was able to do in that routine. Mallory Mordock here for TWU.
Uchenko layout full. Hop backwards, but another great vault for Texas. Texas is definitely coming back from that struggle on bars, and they're looking good.
Really fired up on the vault. This is a really impressive group in that area. They got a 9.60 from Megan Gentry on the previous routine. So we get ready for Megan Severs to go on the uneven bars for Iowa State.
Megan has a great bar routine. And she's always working hard in the gym, focusing on those handstands and form, and she's always working hard on sticking that dismount. You can tell when she doesn't stick that dismount during practice. She gets upset about it, but she'll come back and she'll stick the next turn and for the rest of the day on bars.
Severs season high 9.875, career high 9.9 on the uneven bars. Mordock got a 9.70 over on vault. Still doing some work on Laura Burns' this score. Obviously, with what happened on that, that'll be the score Iowa State will be looking to drop here. We talk about what this puts a little more heat on the competitors, but Iowa State's got a really strong final three on the uneven bars. They're three kids you can definitely trust.
The coaches are definitely putting them in those situations during practice, so when something does happen like this in a competition, they're able to calm down, stay focused, and not worry about that fall.
Burns' score comes in at 8.325, and we'll see Megan Severs get to work here.
Focusing in here. She has a kip hop change into a huge Jaeger, connects to an overshoot. See if she can hit this last handstand, and she does. All she has left is her dismount. She does a half and half out. Beautiful. And she sticks the landing. What a great way to come back after Laura's bar routine.
Great routine by her. You can tell she landed with excitement. She knew she was going to stick that landing. We're going to see it again here. Knew she was going to stick that dismount.
Smiling before she even lands. Great reaction.
The big yell as well. You see the end of Brandy Lazarus's routine.
Uchenko layout full with a hop back, but another great ball for Texas.
we mentioned, we weren't joking, TWU's got some serious vaulters on this team. Lazarus gets congratulated by her teammates.
Yeah, it's a very powerful on vault, as you see, putting up big scores for Texas women's.
Lazarus, senior out of Mustang, Oklahoma, season and career high, 9.825, of which she got last week at Oklahoma. Haley Young getting ready to roll on the uneven bars. Going to get a Megan Siever score here. 9.825 for Megan Sievers. Getting some emotional expressions from Nilsson. I think he thought that was supposed to be a little higher.
For sure, definitely was. Beautiful first handstand for Haley. She was blind change into a Jaeger, just a little close. Hits that handstand, beautiful. A beautiful bail. Let's see if she can hit this last handstand and stick this dismount. She does a double layout. Huge double layout, and she sticks that landing.
Yes.
So exciting for the Cyclones right there.
That was big time from Haley Young. Big score that Iowa State needed there. Season high, 9.85. Career high, 9.875. Both of those numbers could be under serious threat here.
What a beautiful dismount with that excitement again.
See, Shyler Jones there from TWU just wrapped up the vault lineup for the Pioneers. You see Lazarus' score came across there, 9.725 for her. There's your Big 12 event specialist of the week, Hillary Green.
Hillary's great on bars. Every day she comes in working hard on each and every single event. She always focuses on keeping perfect form and on her handstands and landings. Very hard on herself when she doesn't have a day she wants, but she does come in the next day like nothing ever happened, and she'll look even better the next day.
Wonderful feature before the meet by Danny Orris, talking to Hillary about what she's been working on to have an improved senior season after a little bit of a disappointment by her standards last season. Haley Young's score comes in here, 9.825. Wonder if Iowa State will be handing in some forms here, asking about some scores. For now, though, it's all about Hillary Green.
Beautiful mount by Hillary. Hits that first handstand. She also does a blind change into a Jaeger. She hangs on to that bar. She was very far, but she had to stop on that kip. Beautiful bail, though. Just a little shy on that last handstand. Just her dismounted double layout. And she sticks that landing. Besides that kip, that was a great routine done by Hillary.
Let's see how that affects her score, but she got her composure back together. Really strong finish the routine by Hillary Green.
Beautiful double layout and sticking that landing. Always working hard to stick that double layout every single day.
And that will wrap up the second rotation here from Hilton Coliseum. When we return, Mary Rominger will be talking to Nilsson Madero Savage about Iowa State's performance on bars. This is Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by Mediacom.
Tuned inside Hilton Coliseum for the showdown between the Cyclones and the Pioneers. Joining me now on the floor is Coach Savage. Right off the bat, Coach, what was the focus heading into the uneven bars at practice this week?
You know, we've been practicing hard. We have been hitting great routines in the gym, and unfortunately today we had some unconventional mistakes that we're going to have to live with and move on to balance beam and not think about it.
And now, I mean, you guys did have a good performance on the vault heading into the uneven bars, and like you said, things have to pick up a little bit on the beam. What else has to pick up, and what's kind of the focus right now?
Well, it's you know, we have to hit 24 for 24 routines in order to have a good score that we can count towards our RQS, it's the regional qualifying score, and to be ranked in the top 36 in order to go to nationals. That's what we are trying to do every single time that we step on the floor. But today on bars, we had some mistakes that, like I said, was not accounted for, but we're going to have to go back to the gym and to the drawing board and get back to work.
And on the brighter side of things, Young and Severs both had really good showings on the bars. What can you say about the work that they put in at practice?
Look, they have put in the same work that all the other athletes. I mean, we are on a mission to get this team to belong in the top 20 in the nation. In order to do that, everybody has to step up. It doesn't matter that one or two athletes get the job done. It's a team effort.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you for watching Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by Mediacom.
Z's 95.4. You got to look at the Iowa State bar scores there, led by a pair of 9.825s by Severs and Young. 9.725 for Paz, 9.65 for MJ Johnson. Hillary wasn't able to connect to her routine. She got a 9.450, and Laura Burns fell, and her score, 8.325, will not count. As we advance to the balance beam lineup for Iowa State and Courtney Horseman, we got some different names in there from the past few weeks.
Yes, we do. We have Cassie Diaz and Molly Russ in there. They're sophomores, and they've been in the gym working hard to get into this lineup.
Yep. Yep. We'll talk about them when we get to their routines, but now we're going to start off with Sophia Steinmeier. Has been very impressive in that leadoff spot for Iowa State this year on the balance beam. Season high, 9.775.
The first person up on beam is always very important because they set the tone for the rest of the rotation. She's going to start us off with a front toss into a flutter jump. Beautiful. Sophia's definitely starting to open up some. When she first came in, she was very shy. Just a little short on that landing, which forced her to wobble, but she stayed on. Switch leap into a split straddle quarter, sorry. Staying focused, full turn. Perfect. Setting up for her dismount. She does a round off 1.5. This is a hop forwards, but what a great way to start off beam for the Cyclones.
She did a good job holding on to that routine, make it a little easier on her teammates, not putting the pressure on the next five if you have a fall on your first routine. But she's able to hang on to it and finish the routine strongly as we head over to the floor. This is Abigail Versman. Versman season high 9.70, career high 9.725 on the floor. Versman's been a regular on the floor for Texas Women's University. She competed in all their meets on floor last season and has been in their lineup now for the first three meets of their 2018 season.
She has very dramatic music with her dance. Her first pass, double pike with a perfect landing. Very slow dance, which can be good sometimes because it gives you time to breathe. Not as tiring, but you still want to show it off. Switch half or switch side into a straddle full.
When you talk about the slower music, a little more captivating, you try to bring in the judges a little more, and you've seen that. She's done a good job with her facial expressions, looking at the judges, getting her teammates involved.
Yes, for sure. It's very important to look at the judges and try and look around as much as you can because it gives it more of like an impression instead of just looking down at the floor the whole time. It's not as fun to watch then.
Quick update from the balance beam. Sophia Steinmeier got a 9.625.
Great floor routine to start off Texas on floor.
Head back over to the balance beam here. Megan Severs, a little different spot in the lineup. She's been number 5 for this season. This week she's in the number 2 spot.
Last week she had a rough rotation on beam, and I think that's why they put her in second spot, so she doesn't have as much pressure on herself. Mm-hmm.
Hopefully for Iowa State, she can stay relaxed up there.
Just a little wobble on the flight series, but she hangs on.
week one at Arizona State, she set her career high on balance beam with a 9.825. However, the past 2 weeks, she has fallen. She fell against Arizona, and as Courtney mentioned last week at Oklahoma, she fell as well.
Cat leap into a side summy. She looks confident today up there for sure. Doesn't want to make a mistake again for a third week.
Well, that last maneuver was the one that got her at Oklahoma.
Switch leap into a switch leap. Different and a little hard, but she makes it look easy. All she has left is her dismount. Front full, and she sticks that landing. What a way to come back and stay on the beam.
You can see the relief on both her and assistant coach Kristen White's face there. You can see it from their teammates as well. What this is going to mean for Megan's confidence going forward is see that dismount there. So it might not be the biggest score in the world, but as it's the psychological factor. Help her relax, helps her teammates relax, especially when you have two gymnasts who are going to be making their season debuts coming up here in the next two routines. Make things a little easier on them as much as you can, as we get some final scores coming in. Versman got a 9.450 on the floor to lead off for Texas Women's University. You saw on the graphic there, Morgan Colley is up now for TWU, season and career high, 9.675.
As you can hear, different music than the last routine. This is more upbeat. Her first pass, double pike, beautiful. Her teammates are on the sideline getting into the routine with her, pumping her up for her second pass.
Good news over from the balance beam. Megan Severs ties her career high, 9.825.
Front handspring, front full into a front layout. Her teammates are definitely loving this routine. They're jumping all over the place on this side. She's having fun out there with those facial expressions, smiling at the judges, winking at her teammates. It's always important to have fun on floor, because when you're dancing, you just want to let loose and let your personality come out and then focus right in before your tumbling passes. Her last pass here, she does a front handspring, front Rudy, just chest down on the landing, but another great routine on floor for Texas.
Good work by the Pioneers there. Texas Women's University, their season high score on floor is a 48.750 from their first meet of the season against Lindenwood. As you get a look at Molly Russ here, making her season debut on the balance beam. She made a few appearances on the beam last year for Iowa State. Owns a career high of 9.775.
It's exciting to see her back out there. She had a rough first semester, but she's been in the gym working hard to get back in this lineup. Beautiful handspring layout to start out her beam routine. Full turn. Very solid. She looks very confident up there. It looks like she's been competing this routine for a very long time. Switch leap into a switch leap. Just a little mistake, but she hangs on. Split jump into a straddle half, beautiful. All she has left is her dismount. Focusing in. She does a side aerial into a full, and great way to start out her season.
Say she held on to that there. We're right in front of that end of the bounce beam there. You can see her one foot is just kind of slipping. I'm going to see it here again on replay. I want to talk about that.
Yeah, that's her dismount right there. But on her switch leap, you can see her foot was hanging off the side of the beam. But she managed to keep her upper body over the beam so she can stay on that beam and not have to count a fall.
Exactly. Good composure to once again hold on to those routines, and we'll see if what the judges reward her with as we head back over to the floor exercise. Aaron Alderman is up for the Pioneers.
Another floor routine with very dramatic music.
previous competitor for TWU on floor, Morgan Colley, at a 9.525 for her routine.
She's a very powerful gymnast like we saw on vault. She opens up with a beautiful double pike, perfect landing.
We mentioned earlier in the broadcast, it's been an impressive rise for Colley. Colley is a junior to go from not competing her first 2 years to being a three-event specialist for the Pioneers this year.
It's nice to see those gymnasts who don't compete and come out and do really well on three events. Front full into a front layout, beautiful.
Molly Russ checks in with a 9.575 on the balance beam for the Cyclones.
Getting ready for her last pass. She has a front Rudy, a beautiful routine. Texas is definitely coming back after that rough bar rotation, and they're looking great.
Work by her. Help the Pioneers out in their efforts. Cassandra Diaz. Cassie is a sophomore from Downey, California. Another Cyclone making her season debut.
Yeah, she's been out with some injuries, and it's been getting her down lately, but she still has been going into the gym every day, working hard, proving to the coaches that she deserves to be in this lineup.
Cassie actually got injured at Arizona State on the trip when the team was practicing down there. She was originally slated to be in the beam and floor lineup for that meet before she got injured, so she's worked her way back in the lineup in the past 3 weeks here.
Solid handspring layout. She's up there looking very confident.
When the Cyclones were in Denton last year at Texas Women's University, Cassie Diaz got her career high 9.90 on the beam.
Beautiful switch side before that full turn, and a beautiful full turn. Setting up for her dismount. She does a side aerial full. And just a little hop backwards, but an amazing beam routine by Cassie. And you see Kristen White giving her a big hug. She's definitely excited for that routine.
I can say Kristen White's been going through a lot thinking of how to handle. She was as disappointed as anyone with what happened at Oklahoma last week, having to count a phone, just little rusty and shaky routines all over the place. So she had a lot going through her head as well, deciding on what to do with this lineup. So to see the moves pay off with a solid routine from Russ and a really nice routine from Diaz there gives her relief as much as anybody. See Mallory Mordock getting ready to roll for the Pioneers over on floor.
She opens up her routine with a sky-high double pike with perfect landing.
Erin Alderman got a 9.700 in the previous floor routine for Texas Women's University, and Cassie Diaz starts her season off with a 9.825 over on the balance beam. Really nice score for her.
Texas is definitely having a lot of fun with their routines, as you see with their facial expressions and their smiling. Sky high double tuck as their second pass, another perfect landing. Getting ready for her last pass, taking those last deep breaths that she can. Run up handspring, 1.5 front layout. What a beautiful routine. That's definitely a routine Texas was looking for.
Mordock is a senior from McDonough, Georgia. She's a Georgia Gymnastics Academy person. We've had a lot of Cyclones in the past come from out of that gym, as we see her finish up her routine there once again.
A beautiful routine for her.
Back over on balance beam, Kelsey Paz.
This is another athlete we need to look at on beam. She's very confident on beam, and she always sets a great tone, no matter where she is on this lineup. Beautiful full turn.
Went there about where she was in the lineup. In years past, a lot of times you saw Kelsey in that number one spot being the tone setter, the person to get the Cyclones off to a solid start.
Beautiful front aerial into a back handspring.
really elevated her skills, help her earn these further spots in the lineup to help put up the big scores like she had on week one at Arizona State.
Just a little lob on that shell half. She was supposed to connect another jump out of there. She's going to do a standing layout. Very hard, but she makes it look super easy. Flutter jump into a sheep jump. Beautiful. Into another flutter jump. Getting that connection back in there that she missed before.
Score update from Floor Mordock on a 9.750 for her routine.
Setting up for a dismount. She does a front full. Let's see if she can stick this tonight. And she does. What a beautiful routine for Kelsey Paz.
Great work by Paz there. Congratulated by her teammates and Kristen White. Continuing the Iowa State strong work here on the balance beam. Be another solid score for Iowa State. See that dismount there.
What a great stick and a great routine for Kelsey.
Shyler Jones getting ready to roll for TWU over on the floor. As I mentioned earlier, she is their all-arounder in this competition. Season high 9.875, career high 9.900 for Jones.
Setting up for her first pass. Huge double tuck, perfect landing. She's a beautiful dancer, as you see. Second pass. Double pike, just with her chest down, makes her hop out of it, but she holds on to the landing.
Over on the balance beam, another 9.825 for the Cyclones, this one going to Kelsey Paz.
Her teammates are getting into that routine with her on the sidelines. Getting in those last deep breaths before her last pass. Front layout, ooh, and she does miss that landing. Besides that last pass, what a great routine for Texas.
Tough finish for TWU there for their fifth gymnast. They'll get another gymnast here to try to help drop that score, but they had a lot of good momentum going, looking for another big routine out of one of their better performers and just couldn't hold on to it. And here's Haley Young.
Haley has been in this anchor position for the past 2 years. You can always put her up on beam and trust her to hit her routine. She's always confident and she knows that she can hit this routine all the time.
Right here on Cyclones TV 2 weeks ago, you saw her put up her career high 9.925 on the balance beam.
Beautiful handspring layout. She can definitely do this routine in her sleep with no problems. Cat leap into a switch half. Switch side, actually. She's going to do a side aerial. Into a flutter jump. Since she did not do a switch half and she did a switch side, that is going to lower her start value, but she did add in that flutter jump after that side aerial, so that might help her stay at a 10-0 start value. Setting up for her dismount. Round off double full. Stuck landing. What a great routine for Haley Young.
Big landing for Haley Young. Big hug from Kristen White and congratulations from her teammates. Let's see what the judges determine on her start value. For now, we're going to enjoy that dismount one more time.
A beautiful dismount for Haley.
Great view there and perspective from our camera crew. Great work done by them as always as we see the final gymnast for TWU here on the floor exercise. This is Bridgette Peterson. She's a freshman from Collierville, Tennessee. Only done floor so far in her young TWU career. Owns a career high 9.650.
It's always great to see a freshman as that anchor position because you know that she can hit her routine and the coaches trust her right away, and that's puts a great confident boost on her and her routine.
Just finalizing Jones's score there, Skylar Jones. She got an 8-9-0-0 after she fell on her third pass to end her routine, and it's time to watch Peterson's routine.
First pass for enhanced spring, front Rudy, beautiful. Switch half into a wolf 1.5. She's having a lot of fun out there with this routine. Setting up for her second pass. Front handspring, front layout, front half, beautiful.
Quick update from the balance beam, 9-8-0-0 for Haley Young to wrap up the balance beam scores for the Cyclones.
Getting ready for her last pass. Round off with half, front layout. Ooh, and she does fall on that last pass.
Tough couple of finishes for Texas Women's University on those final two routines, looking for the scores to finish up and almost getting there, but then on the third pass having the falls. Those are tough breaks for TWU as they close out the rotation. As we wrap up and get ready to head to the fourth rotation, we're going to go to a commercial break. When we come back, Mary Rominger will be talking to the boss, head coach.
Coach Jay Rone, and as I mentioned, your team does have the lead heading into this final rotation. What are your thoughts on the team's performance thus far?
We had to do some quick recovery on bars, which it became apparent in the score. So going to beam, where the previous two meets we've struggled, it was something that we really needed to do, is stay on the event, and we were able to do that. I'm proud of the way the team handled it. Molly Russ and Cassie Diaz were in there for the first time, and I think they handled it pretty well. Molly had one mistake in there that she probably will never make again. You know, I think she'll be dreaming about that for the next week or so. Nightmares, really. And I'm pleased with the way that they were able to keep it together through that event. And now heading to an event where they feel pretty confident. I think we're in good shape right now, but we still got to get that job done.
And considering the success that you guys have had throughout the season, what was the mindset in practices heading into this meet, knowing that you guys need to do what you guys have been doing to continue to stay ranked?
Well, you know, one thing is we clearly have had to work on landings, and that's something that's been the focus for the past couple of weeks, so we've been working a lot on that. And then we've done a little bit of a personnel shuffling, you know, giving some people some rest and letting others have some opportunities, and I think that was an important thing for today, because overall that's what our team needs for the long run. It's a long season, and everybody has to contribute or we're not going to make it, you know. It's a rough season.
And you've mentioned that as you have seen new faces and you have exercised the depth in the lineup tonight. Just again, reiterate what you think about what they showed and what they put on the table tonight.
Well, I was just really impressed that the ones that haven't had any experience yet with competition for this season came out here like they've already done three or four meets, and, you know, the kind of veteran performance. You know, it's what we need, and I'm very happy to see it.
All right, thank you, Coach. Good luck with the rest of the meet. And you are watching Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by Mediacom.
6350 to 142.85825 as we get ready to go. It's Iowa State's balance beam scores as Texas Women's University is ready to roll. Brandi Lazarus leading things off for the Pioneers.
A different map there. Very unique. Setting up for her series. Handspring layout, beautiful.
Yeah.
full turn with her leg up. Very different for college gymnastics. You see that a lot in elite gymnastics, but not college. Flutter jump into a split full, beautiful.
Lazarus comes into the meet, season high 9.45 on beam, career high 9.650.
Pitch kick into a switch side, beautiful. Setting up for her dismount. Gainer full, just a small hop backwards, but a great start for Texas on beam.
Good start for the Pioneers there by Lazarus. So we take a look at Sophia Steinmeier, who will lead off the Iowa State floor lineup, which goes as follows. Sophia Steinmeier, Megan Sievers, Brianna Ledesma, Kelsey Paz, Haley Young up to the five spot with a season debut coming for Hillary Green in the sixth slot.
Hillary actually had surgery over the summer on her shoulder, so she's been in the gym coming back, trying to get her cardio up and her routine's perfect so she can be in that anchor spot for floor.
Still some discussion in regards to a Texas Women's University score on floor. The judges were still meeting while Lazarus was going on the beam, but they've gotten everything cleaned up and the judges are just about ready to go in watching Sophia Steinmeier's routine. Just getting a few little things in their house in order. Meanwhile, big score for Lazarus to start off for TWU over on the balance beam, 9.775. Full 10th and a quarter over her previous career high, so a really nice start for the Pioneers on balance beam. TWU struggled a lot at Oklahoma on beam last week, had to count a few falls, so get a start like that's big, and we're gonna watch Sophia Steinmeier on the floor.
Sophia has a great floor routine. She's very powerful on floor. In warm-ups, there were a couple of them warming up their E-passes, so I don't know if we're gonna see those come out today. Setting up for her first pass. Huge double tuck with a perfect landing. Giving the judges a little smirk.
Sophia's season high, 9.675 coming into today's meet.
Run off whip, double pull, beautiful. Sophia's great at back tumbling, flipping, twisting, anything you give her, she'll do it and it will look great.
Floor is a nice event for her. Translate that power that we see on vault and bring it over into the floor.
And like I said on beam, she's starting to open up a lot more, coming in shy, not doing her dance as well as she could, but now she's doing it beautifully. Front handspring from full into a front layout. What a great way to start out floor for the Cyclones.
That's a great point about loosening up, because watching the first three meets and watching her, I've always felt that she was a little stiff doing her floor routine, as we see another pass right there again.
Beautiful way to end that floor routine.
So it's nice to see her open up, and that's going to help her score. As an effect, I think we're going to see that help her score through the judging here as Aaron Adelman gets underway for TWU on the beam.
Switch leap into a gainer layout. Very different. Talking to herself, trying to keep herself calm. Side aerial, just a little wobble. Wolf jump. Ooh, into a straddle, three quarter. Her foot did slip, which caused her to wobble and touch the beam, which they might count that as a fall. Her series handspring layout, very solid. Full turn, beautiful. Setting up for her dismount. Gainer full and a stuck landing. What a great routine.
It's a nice routine for her, said she just didn't touch the beam there on the one move, she'd be in position for another really nice score like Lazarus did. But we'll see what the judges decide on that. But from our perspective, it looked like she did touch the beam. It's going to be counted as such. Megan Seaver's getting ready to go on the floor. We have an intriguing all-around race going here. Megan Seaver's currently the clubhouse leader, three events, 29.5. Haley Young, 29.450. And Kelsey Paz, 29.350. So we'll see what happens with that. Everyone will be very supportive of each other, as we know. But it's still something to watch here as Seaver's gets ready for her first pass.
She does a double tuck. It's huge. Beautiful landing. And like you said, with those three all-arounders, they're great teammates and they're going to support each other, but they're all three of them are going to fight to the end to get that top spot. Megan has a very fun floor routine. Always love watching her floor. Beautiful leap series.
Seavers comes into today's meet. Season high 9.8, career high 9.825.
Second pass for handspring front full front pike. Perfect. Megan has been training a double Arabian in the gym.
Ooh.
And I'm hoping that she can move that to the floor and get that out for the end of season. Because if she does that, it's going to be huge for the Cyclones.
Cindy Converse had a double Arabian in her floor routine, didn't she?
Yeah, she does. And it's huge.
It is. Absolutely enormous.
Beautiful routine to a split jump. What a solid routine for Megan Seavers.
Quick scores update for you as Seaver celebrates her routine. Sophia Steinmeier did set her career high on floor, 9.700. And over on the balance beam, Alderman got a 9.475. As you see some of Seaver's routine there again.
She's definitely happy with that routine.
Yep. So kind of on the beam scoring, kind of split the difference, 9.475. Didn't technically count the fall, but the damage was done either way. So we... there you see the third competitor for TWU on beam. This is Taylor Vincent.
Switch leap, back tuck. She has to wobble, but she does stay on the beam.
Taylor Vincent, season high 9.575, career high 9.825. She's from Tinley Park, Illinois, so the unofficial local of this trip for TWU. And her younger sister, Hunter, is also on the team and is a sophomore.
It's always nice to have a sibling out at school with you, because when you're missing home, you do have that little piece of home with you, just to keep you composed and confident with everything. Cat leap into a switch side.
Quick update over from the floor. Megan Seavers with a 9.775 in her routine.
Another gainer full. She sticks that landing in a great routine for Texas.
Strong finish for the Cyclones there. As we get ready to head back over the floor. It's Dez time. Brianna Ledesma.
Dez is the athlete to look at on floor. She has very powerful tumbling and a very different floor routine than the other girls on the team.
She's been slowly getting back to form this season. They kind of got off to a slow start, but has really been stepping up her game in the past 2 weeks and getting her way back to the 9.85s, 9.875s we've seen from her on floor in the past.
Huge double pike for that opening pass. Slowing it down some, which is very different for Dez. Usually she's powerful and upbeat music. She has a theme for her whole college career. We call her the ninja of the team.
Quick update from the balance beam. Taylor Vincent with a 9.425.
Front handspring, front full, front half, straddle jump into a front tuck. Very different, and she does it perfectly every single time she does it.
So you talk about facials and judging. It's usually positive and upbeat, but Dez does a good job going with her music on this, and she might not have the big smile and to the judges, but the judges are buying in, and so are the fans with how intense she takes it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the theme of her floor routine. Like we said, like she's a ninja slash airbender. Beautiful last pass for Dez. This is going to definitely score high. But being serious during this routine for her helps her out a lot. What a great routine for Dez, for sure.
Fantastic routine for Dez. She loved it. Her teammates loved it. See one of those passes again here.
Huge double tuck. With a perfect landing to end that routine.
So we head back over to the balance beam. This is Alyssa Kelly, the fourth competitor for TWU on the beam. Season high 970, career high 9875.
Setting up for her flight series. She goes handspring layout. Just a little wobble, but what a great series.
That is a really nice series. They're very challenging. And said slight bobble on it, but finished it well.
Switch leap into a wolf full. Ooh, she lost her balance, which caused her to fall off. Full turn. Beautiful.
Quick update over from the floor exercise. Brianna Ledesma, 9800. 9800 for Dez.
Side aerial, very solid. She's finishing this routine off very strong after that fall. Gainer full. Even though she did have that fall, she did finish out that beam routine very solid and confident.
There are great elements in that routine. You can see how she's gotten a 9.875 in her career with that great series, great elements in the middle of it. It's a really nice routine. Kelsey Paz getting ready to go for the Cyclones here. As we mentioned at the start with the lineups, with Hillary Green going in the sixth spot, everyone else has moved up a spot. So Kelsey Paz, who you regularly see in the five spot, a little earlier this week in the four.
She warmed up her double layout during warm-ups earlier. She's only opening up with a double tuck, but she does it beautifully.
Kelsey, season high 9825, career high 9925 in the floor exercise.
It's always fun watching Kelsey on every single event because she has such a bubbly personality. She's always smiling, having fun, always has a great attitude, and it helps the team out a lot. Going into a leap series, switch half. See, she's smiling out there, having a great time. For handspring front full front layout, beautiful. Kelsey has a lot of power, but she does a great job on controlling it with her landings. Straddle full into a wolf full. Getting ready for her last pass.
Quick update over from balance beam. Kelly got a 9.275.
Her handspring front Rudy, back layout, beautiful. What a great routine for Kelsey Paz.
Good work by Kelsey Paz, fired up for that effort on her part. You'll get some love and congratulations from her teammates. You'll see her finish there again.
She definitely has a fun routine and I love watching it every single day.
Mallory Mordock. Underway in the five spot for TWU here, senior from McDonough, Georgia. Season high 9.775, career high 9.875.
Handspring layout, very solid. She looks very confident out there. It's always tough going up there after a fall to hit your routine, but she looks like she's taking it very easily. Giving a little sass to the judges. Front kick over down to the beam. It's very different. Setting up for her dismount here. Round off double full. What a great routine for Texas.
9800 for Kelsey Paz over on floor exercise. So you see the end of Mordock's routine there again.
Huge double full with a beautiful landing. She's definitely happy with that routine.
Really fired up for that. And as you mentioned earlier during her routine, it was a really solid recovery after the fall by Kelly on the previous routine. Haley Young, as I'm going to keep mentioning, so make sure you stick around to see all of our routines. Haley is in the five spot this week. Still have Hillary Green to go.
Haley also warmed up an E-pass. During warm-up, she did a full in. I wonder if she'll be doing it today. Haley also has a very fun routine. Like I said, 2 weeks ago, the Florida choreographer came in to do her routine, and Florida always has some fun routines, so having some of that here in Hilton is a lot of fun. She only does a double tuck too, but it's sky high and perfect. See her teammates in the background getting into the routine with her. Leap series, switch side into a straddle pull, beautiful.
Haley Young with a season high 9850, career high 9925 in the floor exercise.
Her second pass, she goes for handspring front pull, front layout. Just a little low on that front layout, but she pulls off that landing like nothing ever happened.
And score update from the balance beam. Mallory Mordock got a 9850 on the balance beam. Really high score by her.
Setting up for her last pass. She's gonna do a double pike. Huge double pike, perfect landing, and a perfect routine for Haley Young.
A great routine by Haley Young.
Definitely a crowd pleaser for sure.
Yep. And the fans know what to expect out of her. They know what she brings, but it's still exciting to see it every time.
Yes, it is.
See one of her passes here again on the replay.
Beautiful double pike. You see perfect form and a perfect landing. She's definitely gonna score high on that.
Shiloh Jones wrapping up the meet for TWU on the balance beam. Season high 9775, career high 99.
She has a different flight series there. She actually does a runoff into a layout 2 foot. Very difficult to do that because if you go crooked on that round off, you're going right off the beam. Switch leap into a tuck full. It's a little wobble. Something I noticed about all of them is that they talk themselves through their routine to keep them calm and confident. Beautiful kick over into a beat jump.
Over on the floor, Haley Young ties her season high with a 9850.
Setting up for her dismount. Round off 1.5, stuck landing. What a great routine for her.
As we see Jones getting congratulated by her teammates with Haley Young's score and get a quick all-around score update here. Haley Young is going to edge the all-around competition. She finishes with 39.3 to Severs' 39.275. At last but not least, Hillary Green. As we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, this is her first time that we're seeing her on floor season. She can bring it, though. Career high 9.875 on floor.
And I love her routine this year. It brings her attitude out for sure. Very sassy floor routine, like her personality. Round of handspring, huge double pike, perfect landing. Switch side into a straddle full, beautiful. Slowing it down some. Hillary's a beautiful dancer. I always love watching her floor routines.
Score update from the balance beam. Jones finished up with a 9.70 for TWU.
Setting up for her second pass. Front layout, front full, beautiful second pass for Hillary. Big smile on her face.
adding that sass into that routine. She's having a lot of fun out there. Just her last pass left. Teammates cheering her on. Round off double tuck. Just a little short on the landing, but she pulled it out. What a great routine for Hillary.
Good finish by Hillary Green. Good finish by the Cyclones on the floor. Welcome back to Hillary Green in the floor exercise for Iowa State.
Teammates giving her big hugs.
Absolutely, yep. Happy to see her knock that routine out of the park here.
She's been working so hard to get back in that floor lineup, and it's showing off for sure.
Mm-hmm. All right. And say when we return, we'll have some final thoughts on the meet. Plus, we will bring you the awards ceremony. This is Iowa State Gymnastics on Cyclones.tv, powered by MediaCom. Iowa State drops on floor, 48-925 is their final score, leading to a team score of 195.275 as we get ready to toss it over to the awards ceremony. First off, Courtney Horseman, any final thoughts on today's meet?
You know, they came back this week after a tough meet last week, and they handled it really well. They still had some mistakes tonight, but they're going to go into the gym next week and work hard to make sure that doesn't happen for next home meet.
A step in the right direction for Iowa State. And as Courtney mentioned, next home meet, that is next Friday, same time, same place. You got a quad meet next week. As you see there, Big 12 foe West Virginia coming in, also Northern Illinois and Yale. Groundhog Day, February 2nd at 6:30 p.m. And we are going to toss it over to PA announcer John Burnett Larkins for the awards ceremony. For Courtney Horseman, this is Patrick Tarbuck signing off.
And it is time now for our award ceremony this evening. We will begin with the vault competition. Tonight's first place winner in vault, and actually we have a tie. We have two winners in vault tonight with scores of 9.85 from Iowa State University, Megan Severs, and from TWU, Skylar Jones, with a tie, 9.85. In vault. Once again, I'm yours, infractions. It takes me down, pulls me down, pulls me down low. On the uneven bars, we have another tie for first place this evening. The scores, 9.825. Both from Iowa State, Megan Severs and Haley Young. With a tie for first place on bars. And we now move to the balance beam competition, finishing in first place with a score of 9.85 from TWU, Mallory Mordock. Moving to the floor exercise competition, tonight finishing in first place with that score of 9.85. We recognized it just a moment ago from Iowa State, Haley Young. And in the all-around competition, finishing with a total score of 39.3. Let's get her back up once again. Haley Young from Iowa State. And in the final team scoring this evening with a final score of 191.05, the TWU Pioneers. And with a final team score of 195.275, your Iowa State Cyclones. All right. right, fans, make sure you join us on the South Concourse coming up in just a few minutes for a team autograph session with your Cyclone Gymnastics team. Thank you very much for your attendance here tonight. We hope to see you back here at Hilton Coliseum.